everyone. I'm Serenity Caldwell at Apple, and here's what went down on WWDC. The biggest news of the day is definitely Apple Silicon. Hold on. Let's take it from the top.
Good morning.
iOS 14 is here. There's app library and widgets on your home screen. Siri now has 20 times more facts. Hey Siri, how many facts is that?
That's a lot of facts.
Cycling directions are coming to iPhone and to Apple Watch and to Mac. Oh, and hello, EV routing. Digital car keys.
Let me show you how it works.
Mind blown. There are app clips and app clip tags. We learned to scribble in iPadOS 14. Spatial audio comes to AirPods Pro. Oh. Apple Watch now tracks dancing. There's face sharing and a new sleep app. I'm up. We learned about the importance of privacy. Privacy and
privacy principles.
Home cameras have face recognition. Knock, knock. And what about macOS Big Sur? Look at that all new design. Message effects and emoji and messages. New customizable start page, privacy report, and translation in Safari? Très chouette. And did I mention Big Sur is macOS version 11? Then we talked about Unity on Mac, Swift UI, Xcode's document tabs, and how widgets share code across platforms. We met WidgetKit. It helps you build personal, relevant, glanceable interactions.
Now, the awesome thing about WidgetKit is that we can generate this entire configuration UI from your intent completely automatically with no additional work from you.
So cool. Then we explored how you can design dynamic and responsive interfaces in your iPad apps.
Its content can be organized into collapsible sections, and you can interact with it using fluid swipe gestures.
And we learned even more ways to make your apps accessible.
I'll give you a hint. It's shapes.
And we can't forget app clips.
There's no magic. An app clip requires you to create a second application target in Xcode. This app clip target will then contain all the necessary code and assets to handle your app clip experiences.
And HandPose can help you control or interact with an app without touching the screen? Awesome! We discovered how to implement some of the all-new features in Game Center, like achievements. We learned how to integrate motion and haptics on game controllers. And we checked out our score on the leaderboards.
Perhaps the largest change is the option to create a recurring leaderboard.
Who's ready to play?
I'll be demoing how to streamline your app clip experience.
Lumen showed us how to build a great app clip. We got a sneak peek of the architecture of the new Apple Silicon Macs.
In full security mode, new Apple Silicon Macs enjoy the same best-in-class security technologies that exist on iPhone.
And Lisa's chat with former Attorney General Eric Holder was a must-watch. And we can't forget the widgets code along, we're building apps in Swift, the photos picker, car keys, care kit, computer vision, logging in Swift, designing intelligent apps, encrypted DNS. Danny taught us how to troubleshoot Siri media queries.
The way we solve this is to sync additional vocabulary to Siri.
That's helpful. Next, we played around with the Action and Vision app. And speaking of cool, check this out. Keyboard and mouse support for iPad games. Next up, Swift UI.
The new outline and disclosure groups give you the power to tailor the progressive display of information that's just right for your app.
Nick and Jake helped us learn how to optimize a Mac Catalyst app. And that's not all we talked about. Today, we talked about step sequences in Swift Playgrounds and completed the Swan's Quest.
Is everyone ready? Are you ready?
We learned how to design for location privacy and how to keep your app from getting terminated in the background. Well, that's it for WWDC 2020. It really was an incredible week. We missed seeing you in person, but it was great to bring all this to new people in new ways.
It's here that we bring some of our biggest innovations to life.